How are you, Mr. President?
Mr. Vice President.
Nice to see you, sir. Well, I'm delighted to see you again.
And you know, Bud McFarland, the National Security Council.
Congratulations and good luck and everything. I'm proud of you. Akalina. Nice to see you.
Mr. President, Tom's going to read the citation.
Yes.
The President takes pleasure in awarding the Defense Superior Service Medal to Peter T. Metzger. Major Peter T. Metzger, United States Marine Corps, distinguished himself by exceptionally superior service as Marine Corps aide to the President of the United States from June 1982 through August 1984. Major Metzger continually distinguished himself in his unique assignment by superior leadership, exemplary foresight, and tireless effort, which were of paramount importance to the President and the nation. In this highly visible position, he routinely planned and coordinated numerous events of national and international significance. Major Metzger served as the White House agent responsible for supervising the use of Department of Defense resources supporting Commander-in-Chief travel throughout the world. His performance as the principal military coordinator for the 1984 European Summit trip contributed immeasurably to the Office of the President and to the effectiveness of the White House Military Office. The distinctive accomplishments of Major Metzger reflect great credit upon himself, the United States Marine Corps, and the Department of Defense.
First Marine Division is where I'm headed.
I know, and we're going to miss you very much. And in case you ever get civilian clothes on, I'm prepared.
Thank you for coming.
And then we have a pin for you, and you will share these with your sister, I hope.
Peter, you got a smile on
Yes, sir, I can't remember the meeting. Well, God bless you all. Have fun in California. We cannot ignore the military factor here, and security must prevail if we're to go forward with the things that we want to do with the Caribbean Basin Initiative, with the recommendations of the commission as to how we can help economically and social reforms and so forth in those countries down there. And I just want to emphasize that, and I'm open for whatever David anyone would like to say now in the limited time that I have here. I know that Isaac Gomez, I just wanted to say, we're so pleased that you are here and with us.
Very kind of you. I've been allowed for me to be here with you. Thanks very much.
Mr. Kruger, Mr. President,
good to see you.
Mr. Jackson, Mr. President, National Service Director, and Mac McKinney, the Executive Director of Public Affairs, and Mr. Hayes, Mr. President.
Good to see you.
The group has a presentation they would like to make. Mr. President.
Thank you very much. I appreciate this very much. I'm honored.
And also,
in the golf course, there's a shirt.
Thank you.
Keep the sun.
Well,
this will get you every benefit in the world for being an American soldier and our commander in chief, sir. We're proud of you, sir, too.
Well, thank you. You make me very proud.
Why don't we do a group photo?
Could we have a group photo? Yes.
Oh, this one was simple.
We do a separate photograph of just the two gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Well, I appreciate this very much.
So thank you for what you do for military. I appreciate it very much, sir. Thank you.
I don't know many young people out there in those young people that are out there in uniform today. You're just great.
Yeah, proud of you, sir. Mr. President, you have a broad representation, Air Force, Army, Marine Corps, Navy, Air Force. That's what you got.
Well, I know that sometimes, well, as you do, you do have civilian clothes on.
Yes, sir.
Some tie bars there.
Yes, sir. Tie, sir. Thank you very kindly, Mr. President.
I have to tell you one little story. Maybe you've noticed sometimes from some TV shots or something that I return the salutes of those Marines out there. I didn't at first because I knew I wasn't in uniform, and also, but I tried to not do them speak, and the hand wouldn't come down. They just stood there with that salute. So I was over at the Marine headquarters one night, and I said to the General Barrett there, I said, you know, there ought to be some regulation or something. If I'm the commander in chief and they're going to salute me, then I ought to be able to return the salute. This was very early in my first few months here, and he said, well, Mr. President, I think if you did return it, no one would say anything.
Come on, sir.
So I now salute.
That's a great pleasure.
That's right.
Thank you, Mr.
President.
Thank you.
Hi, cousin.
Hello there. How are you?
Bye.
Golly, it's nice to see you.
Hello there. Good to see you again, sir.
Good to see you.
You're looking great.
Well, I feel good.
Good. Good to see you again after all this time.
Yeah, you know something? It is really all this time when I noticed that you called attention to the fact that Jenny, my mother's sister, was your great-great-grandmother. She was my aunt. There's a little generational difference here.
That's true. Sure. But there's even a gap a few years between you and your cousin Charlie, too. He had a few years on you.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yeah. Well, that was because my mother was the youngest of all.
Oh, is that right? Yeah. In the family?
Mm-hmm. And Jenny wasn't the oldest. Elsie was. Not Elsie, but I'm talking about Emily.
Emily?
Emily. seeing you both in uniform here.
Yes, sir.
Ever had any inner service rivalry?
We keep it to a minimum. We just wanted to stop in and let you know that.
Nice to see you again.
It's good to see you.
Oh, you look wonderful. May I present, this is Frank Bowers and Arthur Weber. He is the founder and the publisher of the Consumer Digest. And this is the editor, and they have an award for you. So I'm going to let them present it to you.
Mr. President, in behalf of the editors and publishers of Consumer Digest magazine, we'd like to award you this Distinguished Leadership Award for all you have done on behalf of consumers, as voted by our more than 1 million subscribers to Consumer's Digest magazine. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
It's very heavy.
Yeah, much.
But he's strong.
Yes.
Congratulations. They have just done a survey that you'll be interested in, Mr. President.
Two issues ago, I ran a We the People survey in which I asked my subscribers, among other questions, who they planned on voting for in the next election. And I'm happy to tell you that as of the day before yesterday, the balloting indicated of 2,500 ballots tabulated that you're recording a 62% majority.
Maybe we should let them do all our polling.
By the way, our consumers demand value, and they're saying that you are giving them value.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is a copy of the magazine.
I these two gentlemen.
Yes,
I have one on either side, and why don't we just sort of do a little plug here, just sort of casually.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Well, I thank you very much.
Well, thank you, and good luck in the election, and again, for all of you.